Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. Today we'll be looking at Madyan. What is Madyan? Madyan is mentioned in the Quran 10 times. It is also mentioned in the Bible. In fact, the Bible mentions that Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam had a son by the name of Madyan or Midyan, and he went to a place where he settled. There he had children, he had people that followed him, and the place was then called after him, called Madyan, and the people were also called the Madyan people. So therefore, when we mention the word Madyan, it's mentioned on two things, both a place known in the northwest of the Arabian Peninsula, as well as a people, the Madyan people. Now in the Quran, it's very much associated with Prophet Shu'aib alayhi salam. As well as that, we find that Musa, when he fled away from Pharaoh, he went to the place of Madyan. There he met with Prophet Shu'aib, he worked under him for 10 years, and he also married one of his daughters. On the way back, Musa alayhi salam, on the way back from Madyan towards Egypt, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the signs, the burning bush, and he communicated with Musa alayhi salam. And then he told him to go towards Fir'aun and to preach his message. Of course, the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells him to preach the message is in the most beautiful way. He tells him, اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى فقل له قولا لينا لعله يتذكر أو يخشى. Say to Fir'aun, this ruler, this corrupt ruler, say to him nice, soft words. That's how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructs his prophets, and that's how the prophets go and teach the people, by teaching them through a very gentle way of preaching. Now, going back to Madyan. The word Madyan is mentioned in two surahs that I want to concentrate on. And it's interesting how the other prophets mentioned within the surah as well are looked at. So in Surah Al-A'raf, which is the first surah, we look at a few prophets, Hud, Salih and Shu'aib. وَإِلَىٰ عَادٍ أَخَاهُمْ هُودًا وَإِلَىٰ ثَمُودَ أَخَاهُمْ صَالِحًا وَإِلَىٰ مَدْيَنَ أَخَاهُمْ شُعَيْبًا. Now these verses are mentioned exactly the same in Surah Hud. So Surah number 7 of the Quran and Surah number 11. We see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he sends a prophet to a group of people, he says, وَإِلَىٰ عَادٍ, for example, or let's stick with Madyan. وَإِلَىٰ مَدْيَنَ, to the people of Madyan, أَخَاهُمْ شُعَيْبًا, we sent their brother Shu'aib. SubhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't say, and we sent to the people of Madyan, the corrupt, the Fujar, the Kuffar, these people, we sent them Shu'aib. No, he says, we sent them a brother, their brother from among them. Because, for example, here in this instance, Shu'aib was both born in Madyan, and he was among them, and he was with them like a brother of them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he sends them, he's reminding them, this is like a brother to you. He's a gentle, caring, loving brother. So he mentions the same thing with Salih and with Hud and many other prophets as well. So whenever he mentions them, he mentions as a brother. Now let's fast forward and look at the main surah that we like to concentrate on, which is Surah Ash-Shu'ara, surah number 26 of the Holy Quran. This one's very interesting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts in ayah 106, after about 20 ayah, nearly 20 ayahs each time, he mentions a prophet and their tribe that they went to guide. He says in the first ayah, وَإِذْ قَالَ لَهُمْ أَخُوهُمْ نُوحٌ أَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. When Nuh, their brother Nuh, came to his people and said, why do you not be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? أَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. Then it mentions who? وَإِذْ قَالَ لَهُمْ أَخُوهُمْ هُودٌ, like the other one. And then third, وَإِذْ قَالَ لَهُمْ أَخُوهُمْ صَالِحٌ, and their brother said to them, صالح. Then it says fourth, وَإِذْ قَالَ لَهُمْ أَخُوهُمْ لُوطٌ. All this, their brother Nuh, their brother Hud, their brother Salih, their brother Lut. And then it mentions, وَإِذْ قَالَ لَهُمْ Shu'aib. You see, it didn't mention a key word. It's been mentioned throughout the surah. أَخُوهُمْ نُوحَ, أَخُوهُمْ هُودَ, أَخُوهُمْ صَالِحَ, أَخُوهُمْ لُوط, and Shu'aib, without mentioning the word أَخُوهُمْ. Why? What happened here? We just read a few verses before that. Every time he mentions Shu'aib, he also mentions أخوهم in other surahs, both in Al-A'raf, in Surah Hud, as well as in Surah Al-Ankabut, he mentions وَإِلَىٰ مَدْيَنَ أَخَاهُمْ شُعَيْبًا. Why in this surah, when he's mentioning all the prophets one after another in a beautiful sequence way, he mentions their brother Hud, their brother Nuh, their brother Salih, their brother Lut, he doesn't mention their brother Shu'aib. Look at the verse just before this. The verse just before says, Ayah 176, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم كذب أصحاب الأيكة المرسلين إذ قال لهم شعيب ألا تتقون. What's the difference here? Instead of mentioning مدين, it mentions أصحاب الأيكة. أصحاب الأيكة is actually one of the other names that the people of Madian were known, because they used to worship a tree called the Aika. So Ashab al-Aika, the people of the tree, the people that they worship the tree, we sent who? We sent Shu'aib. Here, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses their religious identity as worshipping a tree, he doesn't put with it the word brother, Shu'aib. Even though in every other place, when he mentions them as a people, as a nation of Madian, as the Madianite people, as the Madian people, he always mentions the word brother. Because when Shu'aib comes, he comes from Madian. He's the same race as them. He's with them. He's among them. They're their brothers. They're brothers, one among the other. But here, when he mentions their religious identity as the people who are worshipping the tree, he says, وَإِذْ قَالَ لَهُمْ شُعَيْبٌ, not وَإِذْ قَالَ لَهُمْ أَخُوهُمْ شُعَيْبٌ. Even though the verses one after another, one after another, were mentioning brother, 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 but here because their religious identity was mentioned, Allah removed the word brother. Look at how specific Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with his wording. So any word that is mentioned, any word that isn't mentioned, there's a reason for it in the Holy Quran. وَصَلَّهُمْ عَلَى مُحَمَّدْ وَآلِ مُحَمَّدْ.